These are five books about habits. These are some of my favorites. I'm going to share a quote and some thoughts about each of these. First one, Atomic Habits. This is, I'll just say it, best nonfiction book as far as like self-development goes. Just get this, read this 12 times. You'll be in good shape. What it reminded me of, this quote will be, there's this scene in The Matrix where Neo gets distracted, of course, by the woman in the red dress. It's this very obvious thing. And the idea here from Atomic Habits is make it obvious. He tells this story about, this is by James Clear. He tells the story about wanting to eat more apples, and he had them in the bottom shelf in the crisper of the fridge. And of course, you don't see it, you don't eat it. He put it on the counter, and then he says, almost like magic, I began eating a few apples each day simply because they were obvious rather than out of sight. Make it obvious. Make your habits obvious. This second book is called What You Do Is Who You Are. This is more about business and things that you do, but there's one important thing in here that has stuck with me, and what it reminded me of is Fight Club, of course. First rule of Fight Club, don't talk about Fight Club. It's a shocking rule. Why do you not want to? And he just has like different rules. And actually, that's not the shocking thing. The shocking rule is number two, because it's the same rule as the first one. Don't talk about it. And in What You Do Is Who You Are, Ben Horowitz talks about using shocking rules to establish culture. He has four things here. He talks about making it memorable, making this rule raise the question why, making the cultural impact straightforward, and making the rule something employees think about every day. And you can use this. So the thing here is its cultural impact must be straightforward. As examples, dress codes at work, they've gone from formal to informal, and those were for different reasons. There's one example of CAA using formal attire to go against kind of the informal attire of the time. And then tech companies eventually switched that to be informal in a world of very formal dress. How I've applied this is with broccoli. I try to eat. This is something I'm trying to redo because it was successful last time. I try to eat 1 pound of broccoli every day. And the reason's straightforward. More fiber, more vegetables, feeling of fullness, that sort of thing. So that's my shopping rule, 1 pound of broccoli every day. Then this next one, this third book, Tiny Habits by BJ Fogg. This is going to be a reminder from the movie Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. And it is just this idea of, like the children in that movie, making these things tiny. Make your habits tiny. He talks about two ways to make things tiny, the starter step and scaling back. So what you want to do is make the very first step of your habit super, super small, super, super easy. And then scaling back is to take the habit, whatever you want to count as complete, and then making that very small. The icons I have here, the teeth here, this is an example of making it very tiny. Don't aim to floss all your teeth. Aim to floss the one. And then the basketball here is just the idea of, like, you know, to get that slam dunk, you need that quick first step. Make the step really fast. Next book, The Slight Edge by Jeff Olson. This reminded me of Karate Kid, where he is, you know, wax on, wax off, and then he's also finishing the wood fence. And these are very small things that he's doing all day long. He doesn't even know why at that point, and then eventually learns that these small movements practiced over time add up and makes him an effective fighter. And the idea from The Slight Edge, make it daily. And thinking about this is something that this book has reminded me of, or like really like instilled in me, is that life has a downward pull. So it's this idea that those small good things will add up, but also small bad things will add up. And oftentimes those small bad things are just like the defaults. It's by default, we are often pulled to unhealthy habits, that sort of thing. And that compounding can happen in the negative sense too. If you just like are doing small things to keep up your health, then one day you'll get sick. And then it's this thing where once you don't have your health, then everything else becomes much less important. And then you kind of have to, you can't accomplish the other things that you want without doing that. Last book, The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg. This, of course, reminds me of Yoda and fear leads to anger leads to hate, that speech, because what you want to do is take your habit, make it a keystone habit, and just use kind of the power of keystone habits. Here he describes, so a keystone habit has this domino effect where once you are able to establish a habit, a single habit, then oftentimes that teaches you to establish more and more good habits around that. And then you can kind of chain the habits together as well. But if you're able to very deliberately like create a running habit, then you can apply those principles to start a writing habit, to, as he says here, start eating better, smoking less, using credit cards less frequently. And there's this idea that exercise is one of these keystone habits where exercise spills over, you build discipline in one thing, and then you can build it in others. And those are five books about habits and five quotes. Check these out. Thanks for watching.